हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, क्लास 8, सब्जेक्ट कंप्यूटर, चैप्टर 2। टुडे आई एम टेकिंग चैप्टर 2 इज अवर HTML फर्स्ट। ओके, HTML फर्स्ट। सो फर्स्ट, बिफोर स्टार्टिंग HTML, फर्स्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट इज ए वेबसाइट। ओके, वॉट इज ए वेबसाइट? वी नो वेरी वेल, ए वेबसाइट इज ए कलेक्शन ऑफ टेक्स्ट, इमेजेस, साउंड्स एंड वीडियोस। ओके, इन वेबसाइट, एनी वेबसाइट, फॉर एग्जाम्पल amazon.com, सो दिस वेबसाइट हैव टेक्सचुअल इमेज, साउंड्स एंड वीडियोस ऑफ वेरियस प्रोडक्ट्स, एंड द एड्रेस ऑफ एनी वेबसाइट लुक्स लाइक, फॉर एग्जाम्पल www.google.co.in। सो वी कैन से दिस इज ए एग्जाम्पल ऑफ वेबसाइट। ओके, सो ए वेबसाइट इज ए कलेक्शन ऑफ टेक्स्ट, इमेज, साउंड्स एंड वीडियोज। नाउ वॉट इज ए वेब पेज? ओके, सो ए वेबसाइट हैव मेनी पेजेस, बट ए सिंगल पेज वी कैन से दिस इज ए वेब पेज। ओके, सो ए वेब पेज कैन आइदर बी, सो ए सिंगल पेज ऑफ एनी वेबसाइट वी कैन से वेब पेज, बट हियर वी आई वॉन्ट टू शो द वेब पेज कैन आइदर बी स्टेटिक और डायनेमिक। ओके, स्टेटिक मीन्स इन दिस स्टेटिक पेज शो द सेम कंटेंट ईच टाइम दे आर व्यूड, बट इन डायनेमिक वेब पेज हैव कंटेंट दैट कैन चेंज ईच टाइम दे आर एक्सेस्ड। ओके, सो इन स्टेटिक वेब पेज ऑलवेज सेम कंटेंट यू विल सी अगेन एंड अगेन, सो देर इज नो चेंजेस, बट इन डायनेमिक वेब पेजेस so you can see, we can say every time you can see the new content, for example amazon.com, every time you see the new products. Okay, and when you purchase a product, so you will pay for this, so this website will communicate to you, so we can say this is a dynamic web page. So Flipkart, amazon.com, so this is our dynamic web page. Okay, now what is URL? Okay, so you can see www.google.com, so this is our website name, so we can say this is the URL. okay, so for example we can say any website name on the internet, we can say this is the URL of any website. So we can say every book has its own name. Okay, similarly, so we can say every website has its own unique address called uniform resource locator. Okay, so every website have unique name. Okay, no two website have same name, every website have only one name. Okay, so we can say these are the URL. So every book has its own name, similarly every website has own unique address called uniform resource locator. Now, what is HTML language? So, every website must be written in particular language. So, which language we can use to create a website? So, we can say HTML language. So, we can say, what is the full form of HTML? Hypertext Markup Language. Okay. So, all books are written using a language. For example, English, Hindi. Simply, we know very well all the books written in a particular language, for example, English and Hindi. But similarly, the website are written or developed using a special language, we can say hypertext markup language. We can say HTML language we can use to create any website. Okay? Now what is home page? So you can see any website, so in website when you use www.amazon.com, for example, so it will display the first page of amazon.com. so we can say any web, so first page of any website we can say this is our home page, this is our index page, or we can say this is our root page, base page. So the first page of any website we can say home page. So you can say, for example, book covers page provide us with necessary details like name of book, author, publisher, etc. Similarly, websites begin with a home page. Okay, any website or first page, we can say home page. The first web page of any website is called home page. Okay, now next thing is, which things require designing a website? This thing you require to design a website. For designing website, we require a, first we need a text editor to type the HTML program and to see the output. For this purpose, we can use a web browser to view the result. Okay, we need a web browser to view the result, and we need a text editor to type the HTML program. Okay, so to design a website, we need a text editor. Okay, first we need a notepad program, we can say, to type the HTML coding, and we need a web browser to see the result. So two things we require. Now, what is a text editor? What is a text editor? So, a text editor is a word processing program that can use to type and edit an HTML program. Okay? So, what is a text editor? Is a word processing program that is used to type and edit an HTML program. So, for example, Notepad for Windows and Gedit for Linux. However, the most commonly used HTML editor is Notepad. Okay, so any text editor program, so Notepad we can use to type HTML coding. So Notepad for Windows, Gedit for Linux, and most commonly a text editor is Notepad. Now, what is software that generates HTML code automatically? Here some advanced software. There is no need to write HTML code. You directly type your actual data, and in backend automatically HTML code will generate. So Microsoft FrontPage and Adobe Dreamweaver are the some softwares that generate HTML code automatically. These software are known as WYSI, WYG. Okay, so we can say what you see is what you get. Okay. Directly you can type your actual data, and in backend automatically HTML code will write. So Microsoft FrontPage and Adobe Dreamweaver are some software to generate HTML code automatically. Okay. What is web browser? So we know very well, to see any website, we use Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, Internet Explorer, or in mobile we can use Opera Mini. So we can say this is our web browser. So a web browser is a software which is used to view websites. Okay, the website is display is according to the HTML program written. For example, Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, Internet Explorer, and Opera Mini. These are our web browser. Okay, so first we use web browser, then we type our website name, URL name, then it will display the result. Who was developed the first website, first World Wide Web? So Tim Berners-Lee was developed in 1990 the first web browser, World Wide Web, for next computer. Okay, Tim Berners-Lee was developed in 1990 the first web browser, World Wide Web, for the next computer. Simply, what is a program? A program is a collection of instructions that perform a specific task. Now, what is tag? Okay, when you write HTML program, so here some standard thing, what is a tag? So tags are simple commands which are used to instruct a web browser about how the web page should like. So we must practically, I will show how to use tags, but so we can say tags are simple commands which are used to instruct a web browser about how the web page should like. What is HTML tag? So we can say a HTML tag is composed of name of the element surrounded by angle bracket. Okay, angle bracket we can use. So the HTML tags can be categorized as container tag and HTML tags. Okay, so we will discuss container tags and HTML tags. So first we explain the container tag. So we can say what is container tag? These tags contain text or other text. They consist of a starting tag and ending tag. So container tag means this type of tags have starting and ending tag. every start tag begin with open angle bracket, this type of bracket we can use, okay, less than greater than, and end tag we must use opening and closing, but we must use slash, we must use slash. So end tag is always preceded by a forward slash, so this is our forward slash. For example, title is an HTML element, title you can see the opening title, then the closing, so name is same, but here closing we must use slash is an HTML tag. Here I am showing some example, title, India is a big country, but same title we can use again, but here I am using for closing slash. Here I am using H1 heading, okay, computer, but here again here I am using H1, but before here I am using slash. So opening and closing, but in closing we must use slash, so we can say this is our container tag. Now next thing is explain empty text. So this does don't contain text on any other text, okay, so there is no need to use end text. So br or hr tag are empty tag, okay, so we never use closing tag. Br tag used for break a line, and hr tag we can use horizontal, so there is no need to use again br, and there is no need to use close, we never use slash br, okay, we can use opening br and hr. Br means break line, hr means horizontal line. Here some html tags we will use. Html tag, the first element or root element of any html document, so we must use html. Head tag, it used to give heading of the web page. Title, it is to give the title of web page. Body tag, okay, so we can use body. So body have two attributes, bg color and text. Now p is our paragraph tag, okay, we can create paragraph attribute, we can use align. So align we can use left, right, center and justify its value. h1 to x3, h1 to h6, so to give headings from h1 to h6. Br tag we can use to break a line. Hr tag we can use attribute of hr tag, we can use align, no shade, size, width and color. And this is our comment tag, okay, slash exclaim sign, okay, to give comment in html document. To bold a text we can use bold tag. To italic a text we can use I. To underline a text we can use U, and we can also use font tag, okay, so color, face and size. To center any text we can use center tags. Now last thing is what is attributes, okay, so you can see font tag use color, face and size, so these are our attributes we must use in our opening tag, okay. Now you HR tag, align, no shade, size, width or color, so these are the attribute of HR. So we can say what is attribute, attributes always appear inside the opening tag, okay, and their values inside quotation marks. A tag can have more than one attribute, okay, so all the attributes are made of two things, okay, a name or and a value, okay. Suppose in paragraph tag, so align is our attribute, and left, right, center, these are the values of align, so we will discuss. So practically I will create one video for this purpose, but this is our theoretical part. Okay students, thank you so much.